Hi, in this Excel tutorial, we'll go over how to find cells used in formulas in Excel. Sometimes spreadsheets end up with so many numbers and formulas that it can get confusing figuring out which formulas are affected by which cells. So let's look at an example of how to display the relationship between formulas and cells. And by the way, if you enjoy this tutorial, don't forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel for even more tips. On my screen is data summarizing the number of leads by quarter. To see where the data is coming from that is being used to calculate the percent of leads by quarter, we'll first need to place our cursor in any cell with a formula for which we'd like to trace related cells for. And once we do that, we'll go into the Formulas tab, and in the Formula Auditing section, select Trace Precedents. This uses arrows to show you or trace the cells that affect the result in our formula. So in this case, you see the arrows pointing to the number of leads just to the left of it. To clear the arrows, you can click on Remove Arrows. If we do the same exercise to figure out where the number of leads by quarter is coming from, we see that at the end of the arrow, there's a tiny spreadsheet. This is because the data is coming from a different worksheet. If you double-click on the arrow, a box will come up displaying the path to the location of the data. You can then select the path shown, click OK, and you'll be taken directly to the data. Now, please note that if the path leads to data in another workbook, that workbook must be open or this go-to command will not work, but you'll still see the file path letting you know where the data is located. And once you open the file, you'll be able to use the go-to command option. If, on the other hand, you want to see what formulas our cells may be affecting, we can use trace dependence. That is, what formulas depend on the data in those cells. Placing our cursor in any of these cells and selecting trace dependence, we see two arrows. The blue down arrow is letting us know that this affects the total formula here at the bottom. If you double click on the blue arrow, notice that your selected cell jumped to the total formula. The arrow with the spreadsheet at the end signals that a formula outside of this worksheet is also dependent on this data. Like last time, double-clicking on the data will open the go-to box showing the file path and allowing us to jump directly to that location. So I hope you found this tutorial helpful to learn how to find cells used in formulas by tracing precedents and dependents in Microsoft Excel. If you enjoyed it, please make sure to like the video and don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Thanks!